The only significant thing to do with the Wilburys was Jeff was there, George Harrison was there, some days, and Roy Orbison was there some days, but it was all just it was really Jeff Lynne that created that, because he was the one that brought Roy in and wanted to make a record with Roy for years, and so when he finally did get Roy to come around, and Roy had moved to Los Angeles. Roy came over, we wrote some songs, Jeff and Roy and I. So we just take the same band and say, okay, well, today is Roy's day. And we cut a couple for Roy. And we did the same thing for Randy Newman and other people, So it was just kind of one of those revolving sessions, like whose record is it today? But all the same people, Mike Campbell, this drummer named Phil Jones, and Jeff and myself, sometimes George. So the Wilburys started much later when George wanted to make an extra track for a 12-inch. And that day, he asked us if we'd come help him, and we did. And we needed a studio right away. So Bob Dylan is an old friend of mine and George's. And we called Bob and we said, can we use your studio today? And he said, yeah. And so he got interested. And I think that was the beginning of it all, when the five of us were there and we wrote this song, Handle With Care. And then George took it to the record company, and the record company said, wait a minute, this isn't a B-side. And so then I think you'd have to give George the credit for saying, well, why don't we start a band? And then he just came around to each of us. And so what do you think about starting a group?
Shut down. You're the best thing that I've ever found. Handle me with care. Reputation's changeable. Situation's terrible. But baby, you're adorable. Handle me with care. I'm so tired. Album. It's got the title Volume 1, and I've heard rumors about a Volume 2 existing.
No, it's no, all rumors. There's no, that was, that's everything we did, We don't even have an extra B-side, anything. That's every single thing the Wilburys did.
And will ever do.
Well, I don't know about that. It's too soon to say, really, if we'll do any more. Because everybody's so busy right now. We still keep in touch, We're pretty good pals, really, the Wilburys. We often do more around the coffee table, But I don't know if we'll ever do any more. I think the door remains open there, so we'll have to wait and see. It won't be this year.
Roy Orbison is the tragically dead Wilbury and tragically dead big artist in the rock pop era. How do you feel about the things you've been doing with him at the late stage in his career?
Well, I was very glad to have worked with Roy and to have known him, really. The last year of his life, we spent a lot of time together. We got to know each other really well, really. And I think it's sad, really. When one of your friends dies, it's tough, you know. It's tough to even think about it, really. He phoned me about 3 days before he died, and he was just going on about how happy he was about Wilburys, you know, ain't it great, you know, that sort of thing. And he died. So, you know, I think that's unfortunate, though I feel that somehow I felt that he knew, he could tell that things were going his way, you know, and I wish he could have seen it, you know, but maybe he did see it, you know, maybe he does see it, you know, maybe he's here now. I don't know. I've always felt Roy was okay, you know, from the moment I heard he was dead, I just always felt like Roy was okay. You know, he was a very bright man, a very intelligent place him because you can't replace him. All the rumors about who's joining the Wilburys is just rumors. We had the Wilburys, I promise you, haven't picked anyone to replace anyone, you know. So maybe we will, maybe we won't. I don't think Roy would mind.